Nah, I'm not feeling it.
Was the knight in shining armor in your movie? Would put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste now.
Hey everybody, in this video I made a two-panel double slit maxi skirt. And yes, that is the official name. These are all a few reference pictures I used to come up with the final design and scheme for the skirt. First, you're going to start with your subject and measure from the top of where you want the waistband to sit to wherever you want the skirt to end. Then subtract the width of your waistband and measure again to see how long the actual skirt panels have to be. I wanted my waistband to be 6 cm, so I moved the measuring tape down 6 cm and measured. Your next measurement is around the waist where you want the waistband to sit. I'm sorry my head is in the way, but at that time my head had nowhere else to go. Small scale representation time. Okay, imagine that red piece of fabric is the piece of fabric you are working with. I made the one end 150 centimeters long, and I made it 200 centimeters wide. I'm marking off the second measurements I took for the skirt panel without the waistband. Mine turned out to be 90 centimeters. That little area under there is going to be extra fabric from which you can cut out your waistband. Unless you want your waistband in a contrasting color, and then you just cut it out of the contrasting color. You're going to divide your rectangle, it is a rectangle, in two thirds. The bigger portion, I'd say, is going to be the back panel, and the smaller part of the thirds is going to be the front panel. And cut it all out. That bottom part is the waistband. In hindsight, it's not really that long compared to the other pieces. I cut it a bit shorter, but it's like way shorter. Now we're going to do all that on your fabric. I'm using a four-way stretch t-shirt. When you cut out the waistband, I wanted my waistband to be 6 cm in width. So I doubled that to make 12 cm because you fold the waistband in half to give it a clean edge when you sew it onto the skirt. Running from the mark you made, transfer your waist measurement onto the fabric and cut out. I divided that large panel in thirds and cut out. After that, we're going to do some gathering on the panels. Going to do a long straight stitch all across the short edge of your front panel without back stitching, doing a long running stitch. Repeat on top of the front and back panel. When you get to the end, don't back stitch and cut the thread tails quite long because you're going to pull on them in order to gather the fabric. Lay your panel out and start tugging at the loose threads. I can't remember if it's a top or bottom thread you have to pull, but just try and see which one gives. I'm going to spread the wrinkles or pleats or gathers, whatever you want to call them, out evenly across the panel. I'm doing this on the front short panel just because it's easier to form, but you're going to hold it up to your subject to see if it covers the from about hip bone to hip bone. Or if you want to get technical about this, this has to be a third of your waist measurement. When you're happy with the gathers and you've checked that it's the right length, you can tie off the two tail ends and cut them. If the threads get stuck and don't want to pull anymore, you can pull from the other side. Here I am doing it on the back panel. Fold your waistband in half and sew along the raw edges with a zigzag stitch. When your waistband is sewn together, you're going to fold your waistband in half again to make one big circle. Then you're going to connect the edges. Coming back to the gathered pieces, you're going to sew along the top edge with a zigzag stitch. This is kind of tricky because the gathers like to move around, so just hold them down and stitch along. Make sure you don't remove the first line of stitching until the very end, because that's what's keeping the fabric gap. When you're done with that, you're going to put your waistband on your subject and see if it fits. Hopefully it does. And then I moved it down to where the skirt was going to start. I started pinning on the back panel of the skirt first, starting from the middle of the back of the middle of the back of the waistband and the middle of the back panel. I pinned them together and started working my way around. Now the front panel has to be pinned onto the outside of all those layers. I pinned it onto the inside first, but then I realized, no, don't do that, please don't do that. So you're going to pin it on the outside covering, making sure there's at least a few centimeters covering the, or overlapping the other panel, otherwise there will be like big gaps in your skirt where you'll just see leg, you'll just see so much leg, unless you want that. I mean, that's cool too. So you've got three layers, your waistband, your outside and your inside. After pinning that whole thing together and trying to slip it off the model, which took a long ass time, I'm going to sew all those layers together with a zigzag stitch. Okay, we're almost done, yay. We're going to go back to those original stitches you made with a tiny little pair of thread scissors. You're going to cut them, those original straight stitches. You're going to remove all the threads, and this takes a long time, but you really need to do this, otherwise the skirt won't be able to stretch open. You won't be able to stretch past the seam you made. Focus, thank you. It's pretty tough at some points, but eventually you'll get them all out. And boom. While I was forming one kind of picked up, so we've got a few majestic or billowy shots here. I had some extra fabric left, so I made a 6-year-old sized version of the skirt. We styled this over a panda onesie and flats paired with a unicorn horn. And it's apparently a lot of fun to twirl in. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you guys next week Wednesday. Bye!